And here we are flying back into Reading Airport after our pre-season tour in Turkey. Guys, it went really well. We got knocked out of the semi-finals, but we're back now. And as you can see, coming up in the EFL Championship on the 31st of July, we have our first game against Luton Town away from home. They just got promoted, I believe, and it's going to be an interesting fixture to say the least. And then we have a game against Millwall on the 8th of August, which is a home game, our first home game, which will both be happening in this episode, which is going to be great. But for now, guys, we have got something to focus on. Our stepdad back at his house. We got a text on the last episode from our mum saying she was going to leave back to South Africa and she's sorry. So I got to go and check that she's here or not. And whilst we're walking in, we took a look at some transfers in the taxi. As you can see, Blackburn Rovers assigned Francesco Mira. Dortmund win the race for Gerard Manero. We're just looking at some transfer news before we head in there. And guys, he's locked the gate. He's changed the code. I can't even get in here. So whilst we fiddle with this and try and jump over, FC Barcelona have accepted a £40 million bid for Coutinho from Napoli, which is a pretty big transfer. Just jumped over the fence now, as you can see. Making their way into the house, very angry Mateo at the moment, wants to find out what's going on between his stepdad and his mom. And as he walks in, guys, he sees why. He looks into the lounge and look, he's with another woman. And all I say is, I see why she left. It's because of her, isn't it? And Mateo is just too angry to even say anything else. He just looks over and carries on watching TV. So we end up going back upstairs to look at more transfer news, very angrily trying to decide what we want to do. And as you can see, Ajax have accepted a bid for $33 million from Spurs for Tadic. Real Madrid to seal Leonardo Bonucci signing for $34 million. The guy's just an angry, angry Mateo looking at stuff. But he's got to get into the first game of the championship. We're rushing through at the moment, guys. We have got to this day already. And here we are. So much going on in the home life. So much going on in the game. Hopefully it doesn't affect us too much. This is our upcoming targets for the season. Minimum average rush rating for the next four games of 6. Goals created, 1, and create 3 chances. As you can see, we're back in our center attacking mid space. So the manager obviously liked us in that spot. And he's kept Aljari and he's got Elise on there on the right wing as well. But guys, here we are about to get underway with the very first game of the championship season here with Reading. Still lots to go on in our home life. Got to figure out what to do with our stepdad. And just too angry to deal with it at the moment. It's a big thing. Mum's gone. She wasn't there. There was none of her stuff was there. We were all gone. And he was there with another woman. So that kind of summed itself up. And if that is the case, Mateo's going to have to do something about it, because that's not how you treat somebody. We're going to have to find out what happened, though. As you can see here, though, we've got our... It just came at the wrong time as well. We've got our championship debut coming up right now, away from home. And there he is, the man, Mateo Bright, in his Reading shirt. Number 7 here for his debut. Big game today, guys. Can we put in the performances like we've been putting in preseason? Can we do the deed here in the league, in the games where it matters, in the championship? We have been gifted... I say gifted, but we've been gifted a game against Luton Town to start us off away from home against probably one of the easier teams in the championship. Hopefully that we can see it that way. We'll see how we get on, though. And here we are about to get this game underway now in a very foggy and misty Luton today, guys. It's the first game of the championship season. And here we are getting underway with the first highlight of the game. They're coming forward with the chance, though, 3 minutes in. They're pushing it forward now. Shin on the ball there. He's laying it to Cornick. Cornick there putting it back. And he's laid it backhill nicely in there. Collins on the ball now. Collins cuts back inside. What's he going to do with it? Lays it off there to Moncur. Moncur puts it in. It's been headed across. What a great move from Luton. And they've gone and scored the opening goal of the championship season in the 5th minute of the game, guys. This is the Friday fixture. This is the game before anybody else plays. That's the first goal of the championship this season. And it's gone to Luton against Reading. What a fantastic bit of play there from them to work that around so nicely. The Luton fans are going absolutely crazy here today, and Reading are just stunned. They did not know what just hit them. The ball over the top, chested back in, and a tap in at the back post from the striker. He is very happy with that, scoring the first goal, James Collins, of the EFL championship season, and his first in the campaign as well. Unfortunately for us, guys, we just were not ready for that. And as you can see, we're getting the game back underway now. Here, 9 minutes in, the first chance. Have Reading switched on, or are we going to be sloppy again? Bright on the ball. They're laying it to Olisi. He puts it there to Romanita. Back to Bright. Bright turns on the ball. He's got a good chance to cross this in. Tries to get it in there on the wrong foot. And Slugger grabs that ball. No problem at all. And here's Mete now with the chip through ball. Here's going. Oh, and Yadom, I think, is offside, unfortunately, for Reading. But guys, here we come with another chance now. They've gone short here from the pass. They've chipped it over. It's going to go straight to a Reading player. Yes, it does. It's gone here to Bright. Bright lays it through to Mete. We've got a good chance coming forward now. 23 minutes in. Bright on the ball. He's going to lay it to the overlapping John Swift. John Swift with the shot. How has he missed? That was the chance to equalize against Luton Town, and he's missed it. It would have been an assist on Mateo's debut as well. Unfortunately, it didn't happen. 27 minutes in, here come Luton now. Cornick on the ball, laying it wide, back into the middle to Collins. Collins back here to Cornick with the shot. Raphael with a great save, and Moore gets this one gathered up and up to Richards to get it forward and out of play down the left wing here now. Mateo Bright on the ball. Looks good, like he's got an overlapping run from Algeria. Gets a ball back to feet here. We've got a good chance to get it into the box. Good cross in there, showing what he could do from the left wing as well. And a good save from the goalkeeper to parry that one out. 40 minutes into this game, guys. We're still 1-0 down to Luton here. It is 1-0 at the moment, approaching halftime. And here comes Mateo. He lays it forward there. Good chance for Andy. And he goes and puts it in the back of the net. It is 1-1 on the scoreline just before halftime. And Mateo there going and getting his first ever professional assist, guys. And look at that celebration as well. That is an interesting celebration, to say the least. One of the new FIFA 21 celebrations. That looks pretty funny. And very nice way to celebrate it. Good run there. Lays it through there. The midfielder pushing through the mid and gets a very good power shot away there and goes and equalizes for Reading, guys. His first goal of the season. Reading's first goal of the season goes to Andy Rominda. And we have gone and equalized here just before halftime, which is probably just what we needed before our halftime team talk. And as you can see here, guys, 48 minutes in now. We are back in and into the second half, going the other way now. Headed down there to Bright. Bright's on the ball, pushing forward there. He takes on the defender. He beats him for pace. He hits it across goal, and it's in the back of the net. It is 2-1 to Reading against Luton. Bright goes and scores on his championship debut, making it 2-1, and a very stylish way to do so. Across goal, hits the post, and goes in the bottom corner. What a shot. Great accuracy. Mateo Bright now sitting on an assist and a goal on his debut in the championship. What a game it's already turning out to be against Luton. Can we add to this now, guys? We've taken the lead. We've got the initiative. Can we make this 3-1 now? Or are Luton going to turn this one around? Here we come now forward with Mete on the ball. He's got a chance of his own. He's pushed it up to the cross there to Yaidom. Yaidom's on the ball. Can he get this one in there? A header there from Mateo, and he just can't quite get it into the back of the net. Good save, though, from the goalkeeper, I believe. I think, or maybe it just went out. No, it just went out, sorry. And it's going to be a goal kick to the Luton in this one, guys. 80 minutes in, we're still 2-1 up. Can we get a chance here? We've got a good one pushing forward now. Morrison on the ball at the halfway line to Swift. Swift laying it here to Bright. Bright pushes it forward there to Mete. Back to Bright again. He's going to take the long shot. It's gone in. It's in to make it 3-1 in this game. Another goal for Mateo. He goes and scores. Gets in that wristband. The inspiration of his father just seeping through at the moment, guys. Look at that. What a fantastic game this has turned out to be. What a poor first half, but we turned this one around. Now 3-1 up on the scoreline. Fantastic finesse shot on his right foot from outside the box, and it's gone in the back of the net very nicely indeed. Mateo Bright there scoring in the 83rd minute for his second goal in the EFL Championship, and an assist to boot as well, guys. Can we add any more to this? We're 3-1 up now with 8 minutes to go. We may have just got the winner there. Here we go, pushing up with the second, with the next chance of the game. And it's going to be for Luton at the moment. 87 minutes played. What are they going to do with the ball here? They're laying it around nicely on their defense. They're looking for a way to break through this Reading defense here to try and get one back to make it 3-2. Can they do it? They've laid it short there. They've cut on the edge of the box there. They've got a good chance from Lee, but an easy save from Raphael. Sees it go in the hands, and Bright's on the ball now. That's 90 minutes. Can we make this 4-1 here? He's pushing up. He's got options in the middle. He's laid it there. Mete goes and scores. It is another assist for Bright, guys. Two assists, two goals, and a goal here for Mete makes it 4-1 against Luton in the first game of the championship season. We were 1-0 down, and we turned this one around just before halftime, and then the halftime team talk spurred us on. We've done well. The inspiration from Mateo's dad seeping out of all angles here. Look at this from the 16-year-old. Great assist. And guys, we've gone and won this game in style. It started off poorly, but we really switched on in that second half, and we're 4-1 up now. Mete with his first goal of the season as well. Romanita and two from Mateo. Very nice from the Reading men at the moment. And as you can see here, John Swift being subbed off. And this game should end any second now. There it goes, guys. The first game in the championships this season. A very big win here for Reading. And we have gone top of the table for at least a day or so with that win. Luton looking a bit sorry for themselves after taking the lead. But we've gone and turned that one around very, very nicely. And guys, it's been a fantastic game here. And now that that's over with, we've managed to focus finally. We need to head back and sort a few things out back home. We've got lots to deal with. We've got our mother who hasn't replied or shown up, and we've got our stepfather here doing his thing, and we're just at home at the moment at stepdad's house trying to figure out what we want to do. Do we want to move out? Do we want to start our own life somewhere else? Do we want to grow up and become a bit more of an adult? As you can see in the standings on the league table, Reading are top, and as you can see from Mateo Bright's stats, they've gone up from 67 to 70. 5-star skill moves for some reason. We started at 4, it's really annoying, but that's what's happened. So we are a very tricky little winger. As you can see, guys, we've just finished our workout, and we're here trying to text our mum, just trying to figure out if she's going to reply. I said, "Mum, hello, please reply when you get this message. I'm starting to get worried." And still no replies, maybe because her phone doesn't work in South Africa from her English phone. And I don't know if she has another phone or if she's going to get one. But at the moment, we've got no reply from her, no way of contacting her. She just sent me the text. She must have done it just before she left. And now she's gone. I might need to talk to my stepdad. I might need to take action, maybe move out, maybe get a place of my own. But at the moment, we haven't got that much money coming in. We're going to have to live somewhere small to start with on £600 a week, which is just enough to get ourselves a small apartment. Maybe we just need to move out. Maybe we just need to get out of here. I'm so angry at my stepdad. I don't want to be around him anymore. So guys, we arrived at training the next day, a bit frustrated, but a bit glad to be here, to be out of the house. As you can see, we managed to get our place in team of the week after the first week of games. After that performance, scoring 2 goals and getting 2 assists. A very nice Matteo Bright team of the week there, which is great to see in the center attack and midfield position, I believe. And we're just getting underway with some more training, taking our mind off things. We're really worried about our mother at the moment, but for now we've got to focus on our training, we've got to focus on our game, we've got to make sure we keep putting in the performances and keeping our fitness up. That is the main thing right now, is keeping our fitness up. It's going to be a big one. If we can do that, we can get ourselves on the way to be a very good player here in the championships. And as you can see there, didn't do too well from the corner drill, did get a bit distracted unfortunately with thoughts, but we're going to be heading into the next training drill, which is shooting, which is something we're a bit more adept at, trying to get these in the back of the net to try and get ourselves a decent couple of stat points up. We're only going to be doing 2 trainings every episode, so if there isn't, depending on how many games we go through every episode, which is, should be 2, there should only be 2 training sessions to make sure we don't boost ourselves up too high with training. As you can see here, we have these new training drills with the nets and the players and stuff. And as you can see from the Reading default formation, guys, once again, Bright now up to 70 overall here in center attack and midfield position. One of the better ones in the team now, doing really well. Most players are about 70, so Bright fits right in into the middle there. And we've got the same squad around us, exactly the same. And here we are about to head into the next game of the championship season, guys. Number 2 here at home. It's our home debut at the Mdesi Stadium against Millwall. It's going to be a big game here. If we can get another win here, we will do well enough to push on and get another 3 points on the table. It's going to be a big game though, because we need the 3 points. We're at home. This is Millwall. This isn't Luton. This is another different team. So hopefully we can do some good in this game and get the 3 points on the table. Here we are about to get this one kicked off and underway. Guys, it's Mete on the ball. And hopefully we can keep this up. We've done well in the first one. Luton got 2 goals, 2 assists. And here we are getting this one ready to go. And here we are with the kickoff now, with the first highlight of the game. And it's coming 14 minutes in here to Millwall on the ball now. Leonard, he's pushing forward with it now. A good interception from our player there. Pushes it forward now for Matteo Bright on the ball in the center attacking in position. Can he pass the defenders? Yes, he can. He's crossed them now. He's going to take a shot across. No, he hasn't. I thought he was going to go across goal. And he's gone to the left side instead and fluffed his lines just a little bit there. And tries to get a chest down, and it doesn't quite happen. But it does give away a free kick, which John Swift is going to take here. And the goalkeeper is going to make a nice palm save onto that one. And the defender manages to get this one clear. And here we go now with the next chance. 37 minutes into this game. 0-0 here against Millwall still. And he's on the ball now. And he lays it short there to Mete. Takes the shot. Great save from the goalkeeper once again. And it's gone out of play, guys. And here we come, 43 minutes in, just before halftime. Not much is happening in this game. A couple of chances, but nothing too significant. Nothing game-breaking at the moment. Good play here. Great passing from Reading. A good cross in there to Mete, who can't quite get onto the powerful cross. Too fast at his head. And here we are now, 67 minutes into this game, guys. But then something tragic happens. Look at his arm. Smash into the back of his head. I don't even know what just happened. But all I know is it hurt. It hurt quite a lot. I had to get subbed off in the game out of nowhere. We were having a great game. 72 minutes in, still 0-0. And that's the end of Mateo's game. But I decided we want to watch the rest of the game from the stands. So we watched the rest of the game from the sidelines in the stands. And guys, something incredible happened. I feel a bit sore. I don't think it's too bad. I think I just got concussion from smashing myself in the back of the head. But a through ball here to Laurent goes in the back of the net in the 93rd minute of 1 minute added on. Reading have pulled through without Mateo. They've managed to get the 3 points on the table. Look at this for a game-ending goal. Over stoppage time, the through ball, the sub that came on for the injured Mateo Bright goes and scores the game-winning goal, which is great. I'm happy for the team. It's fantastic to see that happen. I'm sure I'll keep my place no matter what anyway. But Josh Laurent goes and scores in the 90th minute to give Reading all 3 points here against Millwall, which is something Mateo couldn't do. And I think we just got a bit of concussion, like we said, out of that last game, out of that last tackle. So hopefully we won't be too bad. Had a really sore head. I think the reason we got subbed off is because we were a little bit wobbly, a little bit blurry. I don't think it's anything too serious, but we did get subbed off in the 70th minute here just to be safe. I think the manager just wants to make sure I'm okay, which is kind of nice to see that he's not forcing us to play on. And we did get a knock to the head with our own spinning arm. So it was an interesting injury, that's for sure. But Josh Laurent got there going, coming on, getting one shot, one goal and scoring, getting all 3 points here for Reading, guys. And as you can see, we're back home now. We feel a bit better. We're at stepdad's house once again, and Mateo's not happy. He's decided we want to leave, and here they are, both at the front door. And I go and say to them, "Another picture of your kid. I'm leaving. You can't stop me." And with that, guys, Mateo goes upstairs, and we're just gonna pack our bags. We're just gonna go. We haven't even planned this out. We're just gonna go upstairs. I'm so angry at seeing him here with her that I just can't deal with it anymore. I'm gonna go to my room, I'm gonna pack away all my stuff, which isn't much. I've got my two bags, I wanna chuck them on, and we're just gonna leave. We're gonna go somewhere, we're gonna get out of the stepdad's house. We don't wanna be here anymore. Got my two bags on, they're the only ones I've got. Full of all my gear, all my clothes, all my possessions, my laptop, and that's about it. And we're gonna be getting out now and heading out somewhere. I don't know where. Do we wanna rent a house? Do we wanna flat with a teammate? Do we wanna do something? But for now, I think I'm gonna rent a motel room. As you can see, guys, we went to say something, but all I could muster was, "Watch your back. And you." And then I just walked off. That was it. I couldn't say anything else for what he did to her. It's unforgivable. As you can see, guys, we booked a motel room for the night. We're gonna have to go stay there for now, sort ourselves out, and figure out what we're gonna do about our living situation. Let me know in the comments down below your thoughts. That's it for me for now, and I'll see you guys all in the next episode. Peace out.